Hello, and welcome to another Scriptcase tutorial. Today, we're going to be looking at upgrading to some new technology that's now supported by Scriptcase. So I hope this will be useful for you. My name is Nate Carpenter here, and I'm going to be the one presenting this. So as I said, we're going to be upgrading today. We're going to be showing you how to upgrade to PHP 7.3, which is now supported with the latest version of Scriptcase. So just a little bit of an overview of some of the advantages to upgrading to this new version of PHP. So it's faster. It's about 30% faster than PHP 7. So that's going to be pretty useful for almost anyone. Faster technology is usually a better option. It's going to be more secure. There's a lot more security features built into PHP 7.3, so that's good. And then there's going to be longer support and updates from PHP. They're going to be releasing security updates and so forth, which is going to continue to make your software more secure. So that's some of the reasons you might want to upgrade to the new version of PHP with Scriptcase. So let's look at how we do this with Scriptcase now. So we just have five steps here. We're going to back up the old environment. So that's going to include all our projects and everything in there. And then we're going to download a new environment from the Scriptcase website. And we're going to install that new environment then on our development machine. We're going to do that on my Windows machine here. And then we're going to import that backup into the new environment. We're going to go ahead and test it. And then once we've made sure that everything is working correctly, we're going to go ahead and register a new license on that environment, on the new environment. So let's get started with this and let's see how to do this. Alright, so here we are in our old Scriptcase development environment. As you see, we're using 9.4.15. We're going to be upgrading that, and this is our project that we're going to export. So there's a couple different ways we could do this to back it up. The first way is to just export the project. So we go up to Project and then Export Project right here. And wait for that to load here. There we go. We select the project we want to export. It is. And click Export. Pretty simple. It's going to generate a zip file that we can then download to our computer. So here it is generating it here. Give it just a second. There we go. And then we can download it to our computer here. And we can save it wherever we want in our computer. I'm just going to save it in my documents folder. Let it download there. And there it is, all downloaded and secured, so we can import it into our new system when that's ready. The other way we can do this is to back up the entire system. Go to Options and Settings right there. So if you had multiple projects, this might be a little bit better option. You could just import the entire environment in. So wait for settings to load here. And then once that loads, we're going to go under the Services tab to backup. Wait for that to load. And then we can name our backup file name and then click Process. And once we did that, it would create a file just like it did with our project file. We're not going to do that now since I don't want to take the time, but it would work pretty much the same way. So now we need to download the new version. So we're here on the Scriptcase website, and if we go to the download page right here, we can download the newest version for Windows, Mac, or Linux, whichever one you want. And I've already downloaded it here so that we don't have to sit here and wait for the download. So let me just run that now, and I'll show you how the installation works. So we choose the language here. It's English. We can choose whichever language we want. Click OK. And wait for that to come up here. Take just a second. There it is. And so it's welcoming us. Let's click Next on this. Here's the user agreement. We can accept that. Click Next. And now we need to choose where to put it here. So this is the folder that already exists. This is the path right here. And this is where our old installation already exists. And we want to install it alongside that and not remove the old one. So we need to rename this folder right here. Put it right inside the same parent folder, but just name it PHP 7.3 on there so that it's a little bit easier to use. Click Next on that. And then here are the Apache configuration settings. We need to change the port. As you can see, we're using 8090 port for the old installation. Let's change that to 8091 so that there's no conflicts. And there's some other settings here, the time zone, the domain, the email. If you wanted to change those, we're just going to click Next. And now it's going to begin the setup here. And this is going to take just a second. So we're going to skip ahead to where this finishes here so that you don't have to watch this. Okay, so now it's all done. And we can view the README file, and then we can open it up already. We're going to uncheck the README. We're not interested in reading that right now. Now this is just going to open up our new Scriptcase development environment, and it should be all set up and ready to go. So here we go. As you can see, the port is now 8091 instead of 8090, which it was on the old version. So let's log in here. The credentials are admin and admin. And as you can see, this is a trial version, so it expires in 20 days. We'll update the serial in a little bit. Let's log in here using the admin credentials. Wait for that to load. And here we are. Since this is a first time, it's going to do a few other things. And it's going to pop up a little message about some of the support we can get if you have any issues with this. But we can go ahead and say we got that and click OK out of that. And then let it continue loading here. There we go. So now we're logged into our new system with PHP 7.3. And as you can see, the version is now 9.4.16, like so. But the serial is still a demo version of this. So now let's import our project and see if it works. So that's that project we downloaded. So we go to Project, Import Project, just like before, except we're importing instead of exporting. Choose the file we want to import here. Let me find it here on my computer. There it is. So let me select that and include that into our development environment. There it is. And then we just need to click Send, and it will import it into our development environment. Okay, so now we can name it. We're going to leave the name to the default, but if you wanted to rename it, you could do that. Let's click OK. Okay, so now it's restoring all the files here. Wait for that to finish. Okay, so now it's 100% imported. Now we can open the project and generate the source. So let's open the project here. Okay, so here's our project, and as you can see on the menu application, it's outdated because it isn't generated here. Let's go to All Applications, click on that. And as you can see, they're all outdated. Let's select them all down here at the bottom and then click Generate here. Wait for that to load. It'll take just a little bit. Okay, it's generating the source now. It's got about 47 applications, so it's going to take just a little bit. And now it is all done. So let's close this up now. And now, as you can see, all of our applications are updated. It's now updated that. So now let's run our menu application here, and let's see if this actually works. So wait for it to open the application for the menu. And wait for it to load here. Give it just a second. Okay, so here it is, all loaded. And as you can see here, there are these messages saying that it is for trial version only. So we're going to get rid of that now by registering our license on a new environment. So we need to transfer it from the old one here. So that's serial right there. We need to get a new serial for this new environment that we just set up. So we need to go back to the Scriptcase website, need to go to our Scriptcase account. So you log in with the credentials you created. So click on that and then My Scriptcase right here. Wait for that to load. So you got these credentials when you set up your new license here. So once you go to that console there, you can go to serials right here. And then these are the different serials that you've had. This first one here is my currently used one on my old version. As you can see, it's in use. So we just need to click Requests for New Installation. And there's the terms, and then we select a reason here. So we're moving to another computer, which is basically what we're doing. Click OK on that. And then say we read and accepted the terms of responsibility. Click Request on that. So it's going to request a new serial. And there is our new serial right there. So the old one's been canceled. Let's copy that one. And let's go to our new installation now and use this. So we're going to go to Options and Settings right here. And we're going to go to Online Registration under Licenses. Click on that. And let's paste our new serial in there. And then we need to enter our credentials, so our username and our password for our My Scriptcase account. And then click Register. And it's going to check that against the Scriptcase website. And a new one has been successfully registered, so that's all set up. Click OK, and it's going to log us out. So wait for that to load. It's going to bring us around to the login page again. And we can log in and see if this works. Okay, so here is our login page. So let's put in our credentials again, click login, wait for this to log us in, and there we go. There's our new serial all registered correctly and everything. So that's how you migrate to PHP 7.3. That's now supported by Scriptcase. So I hope this is helpful for you. I hope that PHP 7.3 will open up some new possibilities for you with faster and more secure performance. And I'll see you in the next tutorials.